who's going to be able to bring that A game. Nice little move there from Noah. Holds back the Forge Spirit with the Torrent to make sure that Quakeford wasn't able to deny that bottle refill from him. Attempt on to Dream again. To be able to close the gap with Boxy's moving in. There's the combo. Burrow Strike into the Sun Strike. The setup's there for Quakeford to get himself first blood.
Gets the first blood money. Has the power treads. Like, it's not a Quas. It's a Quas Exhort kind of a game because you're playing against Kunkka. You want to be able to, like, deal damage, have some extra damage in the lane, and also you have a really good setup.
Just enough, actually, to allow him to back off into the trees, and they won't look to commit upon him. As Insania is fine, Boxy's going to be able to head himself over towards this top lane. As he'll position himself just in time to start to push back some of this pressure that will be on.
Yeah, good rotation from Boxy. Using that Sandstorm to be able to deal with the push. Insania behind him if something happens. Black hole hits nothing.
All righty. Well, that a bit of a swing and a miss there from Afterlife. The boat does still come crashing down onto Boxy. Boxy, is he able to break his way out of the range?
Still alive.
He is going to get frozen, but there's no damage on Boxy. Boxy's fine, as no one ends up being the one going down. And now with the chase, Mickey swinging across, they're ready to try and get more. They take down Seneko. Immersion charging out of there will live.
Oh, that was a big misplay there from Enigma. You know, not catching anyone. Boxy survives. He's a super tanky. A Bracer has a Raindrop plus a Magic Wand charge. Also, a Baton sitting behind him. Now they're chasing
Mickey. They might just get him as well. Afterlife. He wasn't prepared for Liquid to still be hanging around. Only losing, missing the Black Hole, also missing his life. Do you feel that's the appropriate sort of approach at this stage when you look at how the beginning's gone? Is that the only way that ASM Gambit do win this if they go late?
They might feel they, you know, I'm gonna say needed, but if he wants to scale, so like him going ahead of Midas reveals that they want to play a longer game. You can build Abyssal Blade, you can build Basher on one of the heroes. Like,
oh, here we go.
The Black Hole.
That will not land Afterlife straight into. They have the damage though. Boat comes crashing down onto Mickey. Mickey is still alive. He's gonna be able to walk away.
Not anymore.
And now they're looking to try and turn. Insania. It's gonna go for immersion. I mean, it's a good job Seneca was able to find that connection.
Back in, so
I mean, it's plays like that that, you know, that
it makes the difference.
It makes it, you know, Seneko deserves to get that Midas now. You know, all right, if you're going to be able to pick up kills like that, you can go for the Midas.
Sure.
I mean, they still want to play this farming game. They're not quite ready to make moves themselves. ASM Gambit, Radiance, a recipe away here for Dream.
Everything's recipe away. AA Midas recipe away. They're going to set things up on AA. Easy kill.
Yeah. Top lane Tiger.
Oh, leave him alone. He's
he
so close.
He just wants his Midas. Come on. Oh, they're bullying him. He's just a poor old AA trying to farm his Midas. I mean, how many times? He's got sort of four times whilst he's been on the road to this recipe. Poor old Seneko. He just wants to make some money.
Road to Recipe. That sounds like an episode I would watch of someone trying to get the Midas. 20 minutes. Keeps dying.
I mean, we've seen many a game. Oh, he's queued up four Midases.
Okay, he's going all in. Like, I mean, the big brain play would be not to show Gloves of Haste. Kunkka top lane, Remway stops the charge.
Immersion. Not quite able to get the jump in, Tiger. So they can get him instead. Cursed Crown holding back Immersion for now. The time's before for Boxy to boost the travel over. Jump in onto Dream, they take him down the once with the Sunstrike. Boxy's ready to go for round two, getting the epicenter out. Well, I say that, he's actually able to close quite in on Dream. He's going to hold the epicenter for now, because they don't even need it to kill off the Wraith King. The Meteor comes crashing down, brings him out of the game. They're looking for no one in the trees. There's no one. He's going to get the back of him. Immersion charging back in. He's looking for the grab onto Mickey. Takes him back
A-L-T.
Into the boat.
Does not connect.
Out to the side. He's able to dodge it. Quakeford's trying to chase in here. For the kill, diving beyond the tower. Immersion's going to be dealt with by Tiger and Mickey.
Wraith King felt too secure going in, you know. He has two lives, but still you need to be very careful. Like, there is no save. I'm not sure where Enigma was. I just realized they only managed to get two kills so far.
Boxy. Gonna be able to set up on Immersion. Oh, he's charging out. Quakeford's in position. Tornado puts a stop. So they attempted escape, and now Dream have the time being bought by Tiger here, allowing Mikkei to connect. Sunstrike comes down as well as the Meteor. Dream's gotten the once. He needs help and he needs it now. Ice Blast coming out, pulsing from the sidelines. He's got the Epicenter, good to go. Heads over with
that's
the
burst,
straight over onto no one. The Deafening Blast pushing the two of them back. No one pots the BKB. He's got a run. Boxy's already been able to make it over to the back lines. Takes out Seneko. No one, he's up to the high ground, but Afterlife's in. He's
but there's
found
no
the black
follow
and
up.
The three of them is enough damage to take down Boxy. But that'll be all. He hasn't got anything else to take down the rest of them. Mikkei chasing him up into the base. Afterlife goes down. Mikkei, of course,
still alive.
The Aegis.
Like, that black hole was good if there's teammates around him to actually deal the damage. Like, Kunkka couldn't go back in. He was sitting at 200-300 HP. Now, it might sound stupid, but yeah, it could really work. Especially for those kinds of plays. Soneiko getting caught once again.
Oh, and it's Midas.
Hand of Midas just came
oh,
off cooldown.
No. When you've spent such a lot of hard work went into that Midas. And now he's dead. It's quite fun. She's able to finally catch on to the two of them here. Immersion's out of mana. Afterlife's got to put the BKB and get out. Immersion. Ooh, he's going to be able to dodge the Sunstrike. Only just, but he's able to sweep over towards the mid lane. They're still hunting.
He knows.
The spirits.
Xayah knows where he is.
And Mikkei's going to be able to close the gap. Deafening Blast pushes him into the spirits of Mikkei.
That was nicely done. Like, Xayah just seeing the angle of the charge. And he's like, if he stops, I'm going to know where he is.
Here we go. Seneko's back up. No need to threat, ladies and gentlemen. That Midas will be used.
Eventually.
I mean, he's going to have a struggle stepping up towards the creep wave, though, with Liquid.
He wants it. Like, I...
Or give your life
I've
to get the Midas
in this situation.
Off. Just go straight in.
He wants it.
Midas or Forge Spirit, come on. He doesn't want to step forward. I mean, it's understandable, especially when Boxy's going to make jumps like that. Goes into it onto no one. Immersion will charge forward.
Black Hole is available, but the Liquid is nicely spread. Good terrorize.
Seneko, he didn't get the Midas off yet. Get that Midas off. There we go. Can all rest easy tonight. Top lane though, Dream. He might have to rest right now. They've taken him out once as Mikkei's brought quite far over.
He also has the Midas.
Round.
Turn, use the Midas. He did it.
He did it. It's all good. He may be dead for 50 seconds, but the Midas is used.
ASMR Gambit, you know, the sound of Hand of Midas. That's why it's called ASMR.
Oh, here we go,
Afterlife. They love it. Black Hole only on one.
He's going to drop it on the one. Do they actually have the damage? The Cataclysm goes crashing down. Afterlife taking huge amounts of damage.
Oh, they have it up. Down.
But they've brought down Mikkei. What more can they find, though? It's cost them three heroes off the map right now. None other than Immersion with buyback. You know, this Red King and AA, they're gone. Xayah is trying to finish off the objective. Can the three members of ASM Gambit actually push him back? I don't know, but the Forge Spirit's out. Curse of Avernus in place, the melee racks, it's gonna fall very, very low. Fortification buying a bit of time, Immersion charging in, he's going for quite good, but there's the counterplay. They step forward, they send him up with the ulls, they turn with the meatball and the Deafening Blast. Isn't quite enough to bring Immersion down. And he's, you know, he's making good progress towards that refresher orb. It's got the recipe, first Perseverance will be done. He's gonna be there shortly. Can they get a jump around this Roshan pit though? Afterlife, what's he going to go for? He's not going to get the chance. Boxy moves it straight away with the Burrow Strike. Afterlife gets himself out of the Cataclysm. They're focusing Boxy first. Dream trying to step in Immersion. His charge put to a stop by the Yules. The Tornado holding back this Enigma, making it very hard for Afterlife to get an angle to jump in from. Another Burrow Strike over towards Dream. He's caught in the brambles. Quite for an insane. He continues to just push back the rest of ASM Gambit, making it very hard for them to get back over and protect Dream. As Dream, he'll be burst through the ones.
Has BKB.
Get him with the Burrow Strike. Meteor down now, Dream pots the BKB. No one heads back over, the Burrow time comes to an end. They'll look towards Insania, they'll take down the Abaddon. Afterlife looking for a jump, he jumps over, gets the Black Hole off, onto the IO. BKB pop from no one, have they got enough damage to bring down BKB? BKB's getting low, he tethers up to the high ground, BKB
he's
pop.
Still alive.
BKB's on the run, no one can't catch him. The ice falls down, no one gets kited. The cold snaps out, no one will fall.
Oh, it was just a tiny second too late, because Invoker just blinked onto Enigma. And they're in.
They're ready to do.
Gambit,
to do it.
They have one more fight. That's all they got.
What can Afterlife pull off? Already Boxy starting off the action. Jumping in Afterlife. He's going to go with the Black Hole. He's only caught Insania for now. Then the Cataclysm
and he
just
died.
Tear through him.
That's it.
The Refresher Cataclysm. It's all too much. 2 cents of that insane amount of pure damage just wipes ASM Gambit out of the game. No one's out and down. As Liquid, they've got the whole team alive to keep pushing on. GG is called.
Yeah, that was such a good victory.